constantly talk about responsibility, because we need to be accountable for whatever we do. It's not just about creating a beautiful looking building. Architecture is not a product. Architecture has that expanded idea of creating a good environment. Only architecture cannot change everything, but it needs to be changed holistically. I was born in Bangladesh in a privileged family. There is enormous disparity in human conditions, and we grew up seeing that. I am of a breed who has the knowledge, has the capacity to take the responsibility to reduce the differences between human conditions. In many ways, I'm in debt to my country. I studied in BUET, Bangladesh University of Engineering Technology, and the university gave us education almost for free. And I feel the responsibility that we should be giving back to the society. Architecture, being a part of the building and construction industry, takes a heavy share of the carbon footprint. First of all, whether we need to build or not in a certain location is an important thing to discuss first. And then how responsibly we are sourcing materials, how responsibly we are building, how responsibly are we maintaining them. And there's so many things that needs to be well thought out and thought very responsibly. I always say that a building must breathe. Especially in our context in Bangladesh, where we are living in a subtropical climate, it's important for us to have our buildings as open as possible so that we can have natural ventilation. And that's an absolutely crucially important phenomenon that we should integrate in our architecture. I generally say there are two kinds of architecture. One is architecture of power and the architecture of people. An architecture of power is political power, religious power, cultural, economic power. Generally always sought a kind of permanence, and it's very static. And those kind of architecture in many ways have a certain appeal. I feel that in many of my works also sought that permanence, like if you see the mosque project or the museum. But when you talk about architecture of people, what we call vernacular, especially if you go to the rural areas where architecture was created by people, it was basically about sourcing material locally. It was about responding to the local climate and local techniques, local construction. It was about homogeneity, and it was never static. It's always constantly in a process of evolution, let's say. I am inspired and influenced by both these processes. For me, architecture is not just about building, actually. It's also about a full culture of architecture. And I try to participate in all different kind of ways architecture can be promoted, disseminated, and also practiced. Every project that I've done are very close to me, my heart. But some projects are more closer to me, like the Baitul Rauf Mosque. That was a project that was given to me by my grandmother, and I was not just designing it, but also constructing it, fundraising it, and also it gave me a lot of international acclaim. It's like the projects that we're doing in the Jhors of Bangladesh, all the small projects that we are now taking up in terms of livelihood programs through our foundations the architects have created, making our services as architects available to people. And hopefully there will be more projects to come that will become my more favorite ones. But the changes I would like to see is more about rootedness, more about sourcing locally, building responsibly, including people. You know, we've been conditioned for a very long time into a very capitalistic consumerist culture. It's all about mental conditioning and believing in a better way of living. If you can understand the values of a way of life, I think that can be reversed so that our dependency on fossil fuel can be reduced, or we can live in a much more harmonious way with nature. And that's, it's not a choice, that's how it has to be.